Congratulations on this victory. And to begin things, when you're facing a team like Western Illinois, they do so many things with their different alignments and motions and shifts. It can be hard at times to keep things straight. How were you guys able to decipher some of the things they do defensively?
Yeah, like you said, they had a lot of odd stuff that we needed to take care of. And quite frankly, we didn't know what they were going to do with their new odd stuff. So we had good checks. The coaches put us in the right positions. We got those checks down and, yeah, came out on top. So
I know you guys have talked a lot about trying to force a lot of turnovers. This a Leatherneck team that had only turned it over 5 times in 7 games, but you came up with a couple of turnovers today, and you were on the receiving end of both of them. I know Jordan Brown forced the fumble you jumped on, but you had the INT too. How important was it to try to come up with these turnovers, particularly against an offense like Western's?
Yeah, obviously, getting the ball back to our offense is a huge deal. Our offense is firing on all cylinders, which is great. Jordan, he punched that ball out. That was a really nice play by him. And, yeah, then the interception, he kind of lofted it up for me. So,
You mentioned lofting it up because there's a lot of bodies in that area. What did you see on the INT?
Well, I saw him throwing it. I was working the sideline, and the ball was in the air. I probably didn't have to dive for it and could have probably ran it back a little bit, but it lofted a little more than I thought. But, yeah.
Well, it looks better on the highlights when you dive, Chris.
Yeah, that's all right with me, I suppose.
From an offensive standpoint, when you guys see what they were able to do, that unit up and down the field and tack on points, what sort of an impact does it have on you guys and the confidence defensively when you see what that offense was doing today?
Yeah, it was just good to get back, having all three of the units playing well and defense playing well. We gave up a couple big plays, which we need to take care of. But, yeah, it was good to just get our confidence back on defense.
Big road win, 2 weeks in a row, impressive road wins. But I presume you're very excited to be back at home with that Dakota marker on the line next Saturday.
Yeah, that's the only thing on our mind right now. We got a big one coming back home to Dana J, and that'll be fun. Always good playing there.
Christian, congratulations.
Thank you.
Meanwhile, head coach John Stiglmeyer cleans things up on the far sideline. We'll talk to a young man who cleaned things up between the hash marks today, quarterback Taryn Christian, who threw for 5 touchdowns and ran for another. Taryn, back-to-back performances now on the road where the offense has been able to put up over 50 points. Am I right in saying that there seems to be a rhythm you guys have started to lock into as an offensive unit?
Yeah, we just had a lot of confidence the last few weeks. We didn't really start off valley play like we wanted to, and we knew we had a chip on our shoulder to come out and play well, because sometimes the defense was putting us in good spots to be successful, and we just weren't capitalizing. So we just put an emphasis on doing what we can do, controlling what we control, and just going out and busting our butt every play.
You get the early lead, and then that interception by Quinton Moon, and you fall behind 10-7. How important to have just the quick mindset, almost that shooter's mentality of you put that play behind you and worry about what's coming forward?
Yeah, just move on. I mean, we're going to make some plays. They're going to make some plays too. That's just football. That's how it goes. I mean, if a play doesn't go your way, just put it behind your back, move on, and just go on and continue to be great.
We talk a lot about the exploits of Goddard and Winicky, and no doubt you enjoy having both of them. Have you seen, I don't mean to put you on the spot, but have you seen Winicky make a better catch than he did on the 1 touchdown when you were in the hurry up there in the second quarter?
I don't know if I'd necessarily put it on just that one catch. All of his catches really have some sort of greatness to him. I think he had a one-handed catch on the sideline today that I didn't even see it. I just was like, okay, I threw it to Jake. He's probably going to catch it. It's kind of nothing new with those guys when they're making plays like that. Really, our whole receivers corps, we're just making a lot of plays today. So, I mean, it's exciting to see. It's exciting to be a part of as a quarterback.
In the third quarter, when it's a 7-point game and you're scrambling on third and long from your own end zone, just the importance. Tell me about the play that Winicky makes on the near sideline that gets you a first down, that leads to that touchdown that kind of put everything steamrolling for you.
We always just talk about great players make great plays in great moments. And, I mean, that was just a play where I really just threw it up, hoping just a prayer, honestly. I kind of threw it up towards the sideline just to only give Jake a chance. This is where I honestly didn't even see him come down with the ball. I just heard everybody go crazy, and I knew Jake had it. So great players step up, and he was able to make a play there.
And amid all this talk of the passing game, how vital has it been for you guys to be able to get that running game consistent again, 193 yards on the ground this afternoon?
Obviously, it's a big part of our offense. It's able to open up the field for what we really want to do, and that's just be able to run a lot of run plays and run a lot of pass plays throughout the game plan. So, I mean, When we're running the ball good, it opens up our passing game. When we're passing, it's going to open up the run game. So, I mean, it's just a good balance to have. So when we're capitalizing on both, that's when we're going to be most successful.
You get to be back at home on Saturday after consecutive road games, and doesn't get any bigger than the battle for the Dakota Marker with a top-ranked team coming in, that rivalry and two good programs and everything it means. This is a special Saturday coming up in Brookings.
Yeah, it's going to be exciting. Obviously, we've got the stadium sold out. It's going to be packed in Dana J. It's going to be loud. It's going to be a crazy atmosphere, and I can't wait for Saturday.
Taryn, congratulations. Thank you for your time, and safe travels back.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Thanks for having me.
Taryn Christian, the quarterback of South Dakota State.